guess I'll put this bottom right's probably the least useful. Sound real quick. Testing. Okay, looks like it's working. Let me turn that back off. Just wanted to make sure y'all could hear me. In case anyone wanted to chat, I could respond. Speaking of, let's move the chat to a place where I can actually see the darn thing. That is not what I'm doing. Creative. There's a music specific. I was just making it a creative. Is that a game? Maybe Ableton's in here. No. I'm just gonna put it under creative. I'm not sure what that actually goes for, but whatever. Okay. Let me test. Since I haven't actually applied an instrument yet. So let's get. Turn that down a tad. It's a bit loud. As you start with a good bass when I'm making tunes. Testing the waters. of starting on the keyboard is the way that I go, but not all the time does it actually give me the inspiration I'm looking for. So when that happens, I just grab my actual bass guitar and find something there. Having your hands on an instrument that you're very familiar with can sometimes make all the difference. So I now need to arm the audio track that's here, the monitor to automatic, and arm it. And of course I need to check the tuning. Some musicians will swear that their basses never go out of tune, and that may be the case. You should always check, you never know when a key got bumped. So my theme is a space game, so I need to have a bass line that's very slow and thoughtful. I also need to try to find something that moves, because there is things in the dark of space that are unpleasant and looking to hurt you, but you don't know where they are until they attack. In this particular game, so slow it down though. Some of my regular playing out of the way. It's fogging up my brain. Thank you. concept captured just barely there. So E. The jumps 1, 2 because this is the same as this, so it's B. So it goes E, F sharp, E, F sharp, F sharp, G, B, B sharp. Pretty good start there. So let's actually record it and then we'll clean it up. Yeah, of course I messed it up. Stop recording. Totally botched it. Oh, forgot to hit the right record. Wrong ending note, but let's go ahead and open this and we can fix it. That's the beautiful thing about working in this kind of environment. Even when you goof it up, you can fix it. Zoom out because it's going to be quite obvious. I need to quantize. I'm just going to hit this. It's probably going to get right the first time. Okay, this one is one half step or one part step, whatever. I'm not actually counting. I think these are, that one might not have been off. Yeah, that one wasn't. See right here, this one is on the wrong one as well. Da da. That was too fast. Da, da. That actually sounds pretty good, even though it's not the note I intended, which was this one. Thank you. 60. That sounds pretty cool. Doing my own song. Thank you. could do that again, but cleaner. Sometimes I find it easier to play it at the 120 speed and record what I want at a higher speed. And then I, for some reason, I'm generally more accurate when I do that. Not this time. I just lied. Alright, let's try that again. Guess it's the new slower groove is different. I did one part backwards, but again, the beauty of working in this kind of environment is that doesn't have to wreck my world or my recording. So the first off, I want this to be on time for one. That looks to be mostly accurate, so I'm gonna go ahead and quantize what I have. So, Control U. Oops, that's actually the right one. Da, da, na, na. Na 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 na. So here we have our higher bit. Na 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 na. That's the wrong one. This is where I got mixed up, as the second go around. In general, I like to try to record at least two measures of something to give it a bit more time. Probably shouldn't resize that, but that's what it did. Expand these to make them a bit easier to grab. And we can play from here. That wasn't right as far as the whole thing. Keystroke, because it starts back at the beginning. Loop is already set up right. This one as well is a total of, what is this? Yeah, length of 4, so. Oh, it's because it's times 2, right? I see why. This is actually a measure of 8. Or a total measure of 8. But that one was recorded after I reduced the timeline. Maybe? Am I right about that? Signature 404. Do, 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 do. Start and loop set. I don't see plus 2, minus 2. Eh. It's all good. Goodman. So let's switch back to my bass guitar real quick. I'm gonna listen to it while I play. So I'm going to add a new MIDI track, and in this guy, we're throwing some more spacey sound effects, musical instruments. So let's go with some voices. I like voices in my space. Maybe that one, let's give it a shot. Thank you. the lethargic transition. And then you need that to be max volume or max impact. So let's go ahead and kill this one. This should be the same note the entire way through, so let's truncate it. And then we need to grab the end of our timeline and shrink that as well. This whole thing needs to be at the 9. So I'm going to put an audio, or I guess a MIDI effect. No, this is going to be audio effect. And I need a equalizer on this guy. I'm going to turn down that mid just a little bit. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
260 measures. That's a long time to listen to the same thing and diddle on it. I think that's a good sign. see. Probably need my semi-hollow for the resonance, although I could mic my acoustic. Let me feel this rope out real quick. Might do some acoustic work later, but I'm thinking electric for this one. I want that cleaner sound. Acoustic doesn't have a lot of finger noise. That's mainly what I'm thinking about right now.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Excuse me. Good heavens.
Keyboard. Try to find that last piece of melody I need. I think
I'm kind of onto it, but the guitar makes me want to do a lot more than just basics, which is really what we need here. Sorry if it's making any loud noises. So it's can we modify this one to just be MIDI? Probably not. So I'm gonna add another MIDI track. And I'm gonna switch this to record. No output because there's no instrument. So let's grab a sound. Let's go for something. Let's go stringy. Sure. Maybe without all that resonance. Space amount, zero. You know something I know about this camera? It can definitely support a much wider. Let me see if I can set this to be a different. That's not what I'm looking for. Resolution type, let's go to custom. And we'll set it to. That's a much wider output. So okay, and oh wow, yeah, much wider. We can shrink that back down. Here, now you can see the keyboard and more of me, my hands while playing guitar, if that's something you're interested in watching. I'm gonna adjust this to be this way just a bit. That's what I mean. I'm not a serious keyboard player. This is mainly just so I can have a MIDI interface. But sometimes it's really nice just to have hands on the keys, feeling and experimenting with the music spatially. Like this is a spatial spectrum from. I can see the difference in the spacing. That kind of sounds cool. Let's try hear what that sounds like with everything else. Thank you. I'm really liking that. Just for more atmosphere. Okay, now we need some drums. These aren't always going to be playing. With this drums here, they're going to be doing some interesting things. Because the drums are going to serve multi-purpose. There's going to be a smooth drumming session where things are getting a little bit tense. There's going to be a hard drumming session. And then I'm going to do another couple passes on this. This is just me getting the core concept down. And once I'm done with this, I'll have at least 3, maybe 4 different phases of the song that develop as events in the game transpire. So this one, let's go to the arm for record and choose a drum kit. This one. So nice little diddle. So let's play it with the music and see what we hear.
Thank you. watch that drumstick, so I could actually hit these with him. I'll often play around on drums for a while and then see if I can beat out a simple thing that I like and then make it what I want in the MIDI. Like that last bit. I'm gonna go ahead and open this up, and well, let's go ahead and copy this a few times. And then we're gonna trim this to every 8. Grab this, put this at the last 8th. That should be the next section. And then let's grab this one and just take it from the 19 to the 26. 7. If you look, you can see right here to see how it's faring against the others in time. That's my favorite one so far. So one of my complaints is this is too close to each other. I like the phrasing here, it's fun. So let's, can we just select doing that? Well, that's one way to do it. Good to know. You know, there's a way to split tracks. Not sure I could have done it here before. Sounds pretty good. I'm liking those now too. This is the most promising bit.
Thank you.
guess I should save this. Hi, I am broadcasting, by the way.
Okay. Do you have those lamps in here?
The black lamps?
Yeah, the ones we use for the,
Yeah, they're over there.
Okay. I now have enough room on my table where I can put one there.
Thank you.
case anyone else ever watches this, hope you enjoyed it. Creating music is fun. It often takes a long time to really feel it out and work it out, but it's very relaxing and very rewarding.